Guys, welcome to Tech Design. I hope you're enjoying all my tutorials on sheet metal and other workbenches as well. So if you have not checked my sheet metal workbench or other features, so please go to my channel and select for sheet metal playlist. You will be able to see all the features, commands that are already discussed in my tutorials. So in this video, as the name suggested, we are going to discuss about unbend and rebend. So let us discuss on this command, and then at the end of the video I'm going to show you how why this is required and unbend and rebend in sheet metal. So for that reason I'm just already opened one of the model here, so in order to show you how this works. So as you can see here, unbend and rebends are available in the form group. So I'm just going to go to unbend command. So as you can see here, we need to select a stationary face or a edge. So stationary face is the one which is not going to unbend. So I'm just going to select this base as a stationary face, and then we need to provide a bend. So this bend I'm just going to unbend it. So as soon as you select it, it will show you the preview that how it looks. So now as you can see, in additional curves we have some options over here. So this I'm going to explain with this face, with this edge. So I'll just click OK for this now. Now as you can see here, this bend is unbent, and also the feature is available in our part navigator. So now in the similar way, what I will do is I will just unbend this face. Now as you can see here, on the bend section, we can see some curves and points on this bend. So we want to extract them as well on the unbend section. So what we'll do is I'll just go to unbend and select this, and then I'll just select this bend. And as you can see here, additional curves and points, if you want to extract these curves, you can just select them. So whatever the curves that you have selected, all there will be projected on this bend. So now I have selected these two, and I'll just give hide original curves. So now as soon as you click OK, these original curves are hidden, and those curves are already projected on this bend. So this is the one useful that command that is existing in unbend feature. So now you can have a question like why this unbend is required. So in case if you want to have any feature on this bend face, and then this will be very useful. So you need to unbend like this, and then you can go to sketcher environment on this plane. Okay, click OK, and now what I will do is I'll create one circle here, and I'll finish the sketch, and I'll do a normal cut. I'll click OK. Now what I will do is, you can see here, this exact hole is on the bend face. So I'll just make a rebend. So I'm just going to select this bend. As soon as you select that bend, you can see the it is already bent. So in this situation, suppose if you want to have any feature on the bend section, so you can do unbend and then make whatever the changes you want, and then you can rebend it. So I'll do it again. I'll just go to unbend, and I'll just do unbend for this, and I'll just make one more feature on this bend. So I'll just go to sketcher environment, and let me create a rectangle, and okay, I'll just finish this sketch, and I'll go to normal cut, and I'll trim this portion. Click OK. Now what I'll do is I'll just make a rebend. So go to rebend and select a bend, and as you can see here, so now we have two features that are on that bend face. So only in this case, when you want to have any feature on this bend, you can just use these two commands. Those are very helpful. I hope you understand how this unbend and rebend works, and in which situation you can able to use them. Please subscribe to my channel and hit a like button as well as share my videos, guys. Thank you.